Let's Slide, Fula Young, the Warrior, Zhang Lipeng.
Striking on Fula Young. The leg kicks, the cutting side kicks, the short, rapid hands, and the turning back kicks to the thigh, to the midsection. Front kick there from Zhang.
I like how Edwards utilizing those leg kicks early, but you can see how Zhang's trying to put that pressure on him. He's got the center of the circle. Let's see if Edward just keeps hammering on those leg kicks to keep that distance.
7-2-1 in his last 10 for Zhang Lipeng. Comes here with huge wraps. The man born in Inner Mongolia, now based out of Foshan, China. Body shot nicely done there from Ed Wood. Zhang tries to pick him up and slam him, to no avail though. Posting up with that right arm is Ed Wood.
Nice entry into the takedown. Let's see if Zhang can finish here. Edward's got heavy hips. He's been working hard on his takedown defense, but Zhang is easily able to pass into mount once things hit the ground. Zhang's got heavy hips, good ground and pound. Edward's got to be careful trying to sit up like that.
Zhang, who gets most of his wins on the mat with ground and pound or submissions, also has a background in sanda.
At least in these early stages, Edward has to control the head of Zhang Lipeng, because Zhang likes to posture up and drop ground and pound. Edward did a good job of getting that underhook on the left side, but he has to use both arms to prevent the ground and pound of the left hand of Zhang Lipeng, because he's so heavy with that ground and pound.
Edward's so famous in the Philippines Dragon, and so much media attention on everything he does. Would it have been draining this entire week to have, you know, the media continually questioning if this was going to be his last contest and if he was going to retire after tonight if he lost?
You know, like he's like I told you at the Awak, man, he's very comfortable with it. Like he's, I know he might be on a bit of a slide right now, but he still has that same fire and determination. You know, his quote said it all. He says, when people are doing nothing, they want you to join them. And he says that he's very conditioned for this matchup. He knows exactly what Zhang's going to be doing. And he's, you can see that from this sort of defense that he's got. He knows where Zhang is strong. He's just got to be careful defending this overall aggression coming from Zhang Lipeng right now.
Left hands here from Zhang.
See, he needs to get the underhook on this side so he can get over onto his right side and start to create a little bit of space and movement. But Zhang is using his left arm to drop ground and pound. So Edward is forced to frame off and try to cover, which is an interesting strategic decision from Zhang Lipeng to keep him in this position and utilize the ground and pound. He's so good at punching into advancing his position. So he will hit you, get you thinking about the ground and pound, and then advance his position like he just did. Edward's trying to turtle now, trying to, Zhang's gonna take his back.
Oh, not good here for Edward. Figure four around the body from Zhang. Edward needs to defend with 80 seconds remaining in the opening round here. Aggressive start from Zhang Lipeng.
Good control right here from Zhang. You can see that that's what Edward has to do. Edward has to get his body to the foot side so it takes away some of that squeeze. As long as Edward's body is into the knee side of that body triangle, it's going to be hard for Edward to break this and get out of this position. So he needs to try to get his weight over onto that foot so that some of that pressure can be relieved and he can start to work his way out.
Maybe just a small cut on the hairline on the right side there of Edward Fula Young. Nothing to worry about, still stuck in this figure four. Zhang continues to apply the pressure. Can he find a finish with 30 seconds remaining in the round? Don't forget, we are scored as an overall contest, not round by round.
Edward's doing a good job of defending the submission, but he's getting beat up with the ground and pound. I think because of all the work that he's been doing with the submission defense, he hasn't been able to really progress in his attacking ability. He's got to try to spin. He has to try to spin, but all that pressure's on the knees. So you can see that Zhang is just trying to slowly inch forward and close that distance. I like Edward throwing the kicks, but I'd like to see him be a little bit more active with the hands, especially his right. He's got a beautiful right hand, and he can use it to do some damage. But he has to stop this oncoming pressure from Zhang, because Zhang made it very clear in the first round what he wants to do. He wants to get in tight, close that distance, look for a takedown.
This is most people's vote for the most heated division in all of ONE, the lightweights. Christian Lee, the dominant champion. Nagi Aslanaliev, Aoki, Okrayun, Yuri Lapikas, Timofey Nastukin, the top five. Good leg kick there from Falayan. Overhand right from Zhang, counter uppercut, bolo punch off the right there from Edward. Good evasion from Zhang.
Yeah, Zhang's starting to understand that those leg kicks are going to be a significant weapon of Edward. What does Edward do? Edward mixes things up and goes back to the hands. I like that. Keep coming forward with that 1-2 just to keep Zhang's pressure off.
37 years old, Edward Falaya says he is not done yet.
See, Edward's letting himself get backed up to the wall like that. You can't do that with Zhang. He's just too good on that blast double. Immediately, he gets nice and tight, shoots right in for the takedown, and ends up in half guard. He's going to try to keep Edward flat and then look to pass his guard, or maybe he might just stay here in half guard and do the ground and pound like he did in the first round.
If Edward wants to be in title contention, if he wants to go after the gold held by Christian Lee, he's got to start to put the foot down now. Halfway point of this contest.
But this is a good spot for him to be in, up against that wall. If he can use that wall to start working his way back up, but Zhang's utilizing his right arm to peel him off of the wall so Edward can't use it to stand back up. Edward's got butterfly hooks where his legs are on the inside of the legs there. Yeah, and he was able to push off and create that space. Good job by Edward to work his way back up to his feet.
You know, we talk about Zhang Linping coming in here with huge raps, and he had big raps on himself as well. You know, Mitch, he believes he is ready now for Christian Lee.
Yeah, that's what he told me. He says that after this matchup, he wants Christian Lee, but I think it's really going to be a good litmus test to see how well he's going to transition into ONE Championship. You know, Edward Fuliang has competed against everybody, literally everybody inside ONE Championship. So it's going to be a good sort of measuring stick to see how well he's going to do here. And so far, he is passing this test.
Mitch, that's just going to be confidence and trying to, you know, psych yourself up, because you look at the way that Christian Lee has dismantled every opponent he's faced recently. I mean, he has just taken people apart easily.
Yeah, since moving up to lightweight, Christian Lee has been on another level. But I do like that front punt kick that Zhang's doing. It's really coming right up the middle and snapping the head back of Fuliang. Let's see if Fuliang can defend the takedown here. Ooh, I like the way Zhang spun to the back there, but Edward was wise to it and pushed his back up against the wall so Zhang couldn't spin around and fully take it.
1 minute remaining, second round of three. Edward with the wrist of Zhang. Now Zhang breaks off, drifts back to center circle.
Better round for Edward. These last 5 minutes or so, you've seen Edward's been able to get up twice, stop two takedowns. And he's looking better. I think he's just got to land a bit more significant strikes. Because of the lead that Zhang built up in the first 5 minutes, we're starting to see that Edward's working his way back into it by landing some of these shots and also defending the takedowns. That scores.
Mitch, you've seen the evolution of Edward Falayang from ONE Championship ONE 10 years ago to today. And what's the biggest change you've seen over the years to Edward?
It's definitely his wrestling. Like, we've always seen, like, I remember back in 2010, you know, Edward has always demonstrated, you know, this type of wushu style striking. But it's his ability. This is This is an improved Edward Foley. Look at that. Stopping the takedown now. That's what happens when you shoot a blind takedown on Edward. He's going to see it coming. Edward's kind of got that number. So Zhang needs to, you know, get back to what he did well. I'd like to see that aggression coming with the hands, getting Edward back, shooting in the middle like this on these blind takedowns. Edward's going to see that coming, and he's going to stop it.
Leg kick from Edward Folaya in the traditional Team Lakai red trunks. He has been the big brother of the Team Lakai camp for so long. He's the one they all look up to, all the guys. Joshua Pascio and Kevin Bellignon and Honorio Benario. All the inspiration. When he won the championship gold, Manny Pacquiao put the belt around him.
Every one of these kicks, Edwards inching his way back into this matchup. The match is judged in its entirety, ladies and gentlemen, not round by round. So we judge it as a whole, as one big matchup.
Now there is instruction again coming from the corner of Zhang. We can't understand. What do you assume they are saying, Dragon?
He's got to apply more pressure. See, this is the range that Edward wants. He wants you standing at distance and then picking you apart with these shots. Throwing the leg kicks, throwing the punches, and that's exactly what he's doing. Here, he's starting to back Edward up against the wall. Oh, nice uppercut landed by Zhang. But Zhang's going to shoot for a takedown as soon as Edward. Yep. Good job, though. But he shot it blind. He didn't set that up with punches. Zhang's best takedowns are when Edward's against the wall and punches are first and then the double leg.
Mitch Chilson, as always, with his crystal ball, working overtime, seeing things before they happen. Edward, with 2:50 remaining, must make a statement tonight. The veteran, the former world champion. So too does Zhang Lingpeng. If Zhang wants to earn the respect of this lightweight division where Christian Li is the king, the dominant king, in a division with Dagi and Eddie Alvarez and Okra Yun and Shinya Aoki, Nastukin, monster division. If he wants to be a part of the top five, Zhang needs to send a message. Has he done that so far, though?
He's having a hard time pulling the trigger. I think Edwards kind of earned that respect, especially in the second round, because some of these shots are landing heavy. You can just see the thud that Edward puts into a lot of these shots. Nice little check hook there landed by Zhang as he's coming in.
You know, let's not forget, it wasn't so long ago that Edward Folaya had Eddie Alvarez's number, almost beat him, was a whisker away before he made a cardinal mistake in going to the ground with Eddie. But he almost beat him. The leg kicks, Mitch.
Yeah, it's all about these kicks coming from Edward. You know, he's really able to control the distance and place the match where he wants when he's able to land these shots.
Turning back kick, nicely done there from Zhang Lingpeng. Glances up at the big screen inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium, which says we have 1:15 remaining.
I think this is a very important 75 seconds, Michael. This match is really close at this point. I know Zhang landed a couple of takedowns in the second, like right around that 8-minute or 7-minute mark, and then he had a really good first 5 minutes. But Edward, in the latter half of this match, since about that 9-minute mark, has really just been able to showcase some improved striking, but Zhang's got that pressure. So it's really gonna come down to the, you know, what are the judges looking for? What's catching their eye?
Jab there from Zhang. Hook to a takedown attempt from Zhang. Nice defense from Edward.
See, better takedown that time because he had to punch to it first. He threw the hook first and then he went into the takedown. He was able to land it. But that's a huge takedown, Michael. And to land in side control like that.
Could this be the determining factor for Zhang Lingpeng? That big takedown to side control. Is it what tips the judges over in his favor? It's going to be close.
Fence again.
Remember, folks, it is judged as an overall 15-minute contest, not as three individual 5-minute rounds. And there it is. We are going down to the judges. There are three of them circle side. who won as an overall contest. Let us know your thoughts now on Twitter, on Facebook, on Instagram, at One Championship. Mitch, close, very close.
Ooh, Michael, yeah. I mean, it's really a close matchup. Edward was able to do some good work on the feet, but he never really, it looked like he didn't really have Zhang hurt a lot, cased in the first. The second round was pretty close, and Edward was able to defend and get back up to his feet, but that was a beautiful uppercut landed by Zhang Lipang right there. But then it was the last takedown. Look at this. Edward sprawls heavy. Zhang transitions to a high crotch, and then picks Edward up and takes him for the ride, ends up in side control. That
your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Zhang.